Today you were supposed to have finished reading Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, and I'd like to know what it is you think the bard was trying to tell us.
I think he was saying that you need to stay on your own turf when looking up a babe.
Okay, very good. Cindy.
I think he was saying that an obsessive love is sort of a mania that can lead to destruction.
Interesting. Amy.
He was saying that any emotion taken too far is destructive, like the Capulets hating the Montagues and vice versa.
No, man, the Capulets had a right to fight. The Montagues drew first blood.
That's ridiculous. Right.
Yes.
Violence only begets violence, and there's no right in it.
You live in a fantasy, man. Reality is to stand by your own.
Okay, come on. Anybody else have anything to say? Tina.
Well, I thought it was supposed to be a love story. I mean, it was so beautiful how Romeo loved Juliet. It was so romantic.
It was a very romantic story, wasn't it? Okay, here's some points I want you to take down. We'll be writing a paper on this next week.
How could they be so stupid? How could they be so heartless? It was so obviously a love story. A mania leading to destruction. Well, of course Cindy would feel that way. Her long string of boyfriends, which she dumped, chase her around like rabid dogs in heat. I'm surprised she finished the book at all. She has a hard time reading road signs. She is so superficial. I don't know what those guys see in her. Oh, and TJ, typical jock, has to be the comedian all the time. His idea of romance is paying for his date's dinner. Still, 90% of the girls on campus cling to him like socks fresh from the dryer. Ugh, he smells like a locker room. Well, there's no accounting for taste, I guess. Lastly, Amy, Little Miss Popularity. President of half a dozen clubs and lead cheerleader. The earth would teeter on its axis if she ever got sick or left school. That's what she thinks. Who needs a ski club or a dance committee or fundraisers for a new stadium? Why are people so shallow? Why can't they think deep thoughts every once in a while? Oh, Romeo, Romeo. Wherefore art thou, Romeo?
I think that I shall never see a poem as lovely as a dream.
Remember, the assignment was to incorporate something natural with something abstract from your mind into one drawing. We'll finish up here in about a half an hour.
Good, Truman. Interesting.
The trees always reminded me of a woman. It's graceful, delicate. Very feminine.
He's always saying something
I
like
know,
that.
He's such a jerk.
You know, I think you're right. That tree is a female. You know, I never noticed that before.
They only laugh because they haven't eyes to see nature's hidden beauties. All they understand is superficial coverings. Look at her. She must have 15 layers of makeup on her face. And him, he falls for her grotesque display. She may as well put plates in her lips and pierce her nose with a bone. They're all so savage, creatures of lust and excess.
Very interesting. What is it?
They're daisies.
I don't see any daisies.
I thought them up in my head.
We were supposed to draw from life, and then think up an external abstract component to incorporate into that drawing.
Oops! Guess I'll start over again.
Doesn't she know she's a walking cliché? I'll bet she has a room full of unicorns and a Life's a Beach bumper sticker on her VW. I wish girls now were like they were in the old movies. Why did Haley Mills have to grow up?
Oops.
Next, please.
Anything else?
No.
Look at her. It's girls like her that ruin it for girls like me. They make guys think that's what they should want. Well, all that glitters is not gold. Sometimes the dullest stone when polished turns into a diamond.
Thanks. Next, please. Anything else?
No.
Who does she think she is? Christy Brinkley?